अस्सलाम वालेकुम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। आई एम डॉक्टर शहाना एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग दी फार्मेसी प्रैक्टिस। वी आर 44th ईयर फार्मेसी प्रैक्टिस। वी वर डिस्कसिंग दी मायोकार्डियल इंफार्क्शन। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस दी कैल्शियम चैनल ब्लॉकर एंड दी बीटा ब्लॉकर्स। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस दी यूज ऑफ दी स्टैटिन ड्यूरिंग दी मायोकार्डियल इंफार्क्शन। There are several types of the drugs available that are meant for the hyperlipidemia, and basically coronary heart disease is the leading cause, which is mainly related to the elevated levels of the LDL-C, which is a bad cholesterol, and the elevated level of the triglycerides. While it is also associated with the low level of the high density lipoprotein. This is the main positive factor that lead to the obesity, hypertension, diabetes and myocardial infarction, heart failure. There are several types of drugs available for hyperlipidemia. Among them, niacin, fibrates, bile acid binding resins, cholesterol absorption inhibitors and omega-3 fatty acids and HMG CoA reductase inhibitors. For all types of the drugs available, statins is the most important choice to reduce the LDL concentration. They are considered as a first line of the treatment for the acute symptoms of the cardiovascular disorder. They are useful for the stabilization of the plaque and the improvement of the coronary endothelial functions, inhibition of the platelet thrombus formation and anti-inflammatory activities. These drugs are HMG CoA reductase inhibitor, which is a rate limiting step in the cholesterol synthesis. So the main idea is to normalize the lipid profile by reducing the bad cholesterol, which is the LDL. There are too many types of the HMG CoA reductase inhibitors are available, that are simvastatin, pravastatin, atorvastatin, fluvastatin, pitavastatin. Among them, the most common one is the that are used in during the myocardial infarction are the atorvastatin and the rosuvastatin 30 mg prior to PCI. They are reserved to reduce the frequency of the periprocedural myocardial infarction following the percutaneous coronary infusion. Almost 27% reduction is observed after the use of the statins for the reduction in the myocardial infarction. And they basically stabilizes the or inhibit the buildup of the plaque in the coronary artery. Doses will be the atorvastatin 40 mg and rosuvastatin 20 mg. If we talk about the adverse reactions, they are responsible for the elevation of the liver enzyme. Almost all statins are capable and they are metabolized in the liver, while some metabolites retaining their activities. Their excretion is basically through the bile and feces, due to which the main target organ is the liver. Liver's function should be evaluated prior to the starting the therapy. And if the patient has a symptoms of the consistent with the liver dysfunction, then it should be avoided. Other adverse effects are the myopathy and the rhabdomyolysis, that is the disintegration of the skeletal muscles, which is a rare type of the adverse effect. One more important thing is to remember that this statins basically increases the effect of the warfarin. So remember, in case of myocardial infarction, we may have to use certain types of anticoagulant, and we avoid the combination of warfarin with the statins. They are also contraindicated in the pregnancy. So along with the liver function test, INR ratio should be also be checked to determine the tendency of the bleeding and the changing in the clotting pattern of a person. Other drugs which are helpful during the myocardial infarction or after the myocardial infarction are the ACE inhibitors. ACE inhibitors are very beneficial in the post myocardial infarction patients, and they mainly preventing the remodeling of the heart. They inhibit the workload of the heart and they preventing the left ventricular dysfunction. In practice, what types of the angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors are prescribed? These are the captopril enalapril, ranibril, and trenbolapril or zephenopril. They are started within 24 hours to 16 days following an acute myocardial infarction that improves the left ventricular ejection fraction at 1 month to 1 year. The most important thing of the ACE inhibitor is that they can be prescribed along with the other drugs of the heart, like they can easily combine with the beta blockers and diuretics and digoxin. They can easily given along with the aldosterone antagonist, isosorbide dinitrite fixed combination, and even they are already present in several types of the brands available, in which several combinations are there. That are fixed combinations are available. So, in case of comorbidity, for example, in case of hypertension along with the myocardial infarction, or if in case of hypertension along with diabetes and myocardial infarction, ACE inhibitors are a good choice. What are the problems that are associated with the ACE inhibitors are the due to the production of the bradykinins, basically the enzyme. ACE inhibitors inhibit not only the one enzyme responsible for the other for angiogenesis, but also affects the production of the bradykinin, which leads to its different types of adverse effects, like the cough, like the angioedema. So, the alternatives of the ACE inhibitors are the ARBs, which are the angiotensin receptor blocker, that are substitute for the ACE inhibitors in those patients who cannot tolerate the ACE inhibitors. ARBs do not affect the bradykinin levels. So the choices are losartan and valsartan. Losartan is a prototype of a drug that undergo extensive first pass hepatic metabolism. So the good choice is the valsartan. The problem with valsartan is that it is prescribed twice a day. Other choices are there, just like candesartan, which is once daily. Side effects are somewhat similar with the with respect to the ACE inhibitors. However, they have a lower incidence of the cough and angioedema. Both are contraindicated in the pregnancy. What is the choice of the antiplatelet therapy during the myocardial infarction? Myocardial infarction is a problem which is basically due to the formation of thrombus or emboli, and this emboli at the main initiation step is the formation of the platelet plaque. By antiplatelet therapy, we are basically focusing on reduction of the formation of the platelet plaque. That is the very first step of the generation of the atherosclerotic plaque in the coronary artery. These antiplatelets basically decreases the formation of platelet-rich clot, or decrease the action of the chemical signals that promote the platelet aggregations. If we talk about the mechanisms, the platelet aggregation inhibitors either are COX-1 inhibitors, or they block the GP2B3A or ADP receptors, so they interfering the signals that promote the platelet aggregations. The main drug is the aspirin at low doses, that is 162 to 325 mg or 150 to 300 mg per day orally. It is capable of providing the protective effect for the formation of the platelet plaques in the intact coronary artery. If we talk about the analgesic dose, the dose is somewhat high, up to 1000 mg. It is a selective COX-1 inhibitor in platelets, a irreversible antagonist blocker of the COX-1. So, thromboxane A2 formation is inhibited, which results in the decrease or reduction of the platelet aggregation and vasoconstriction. This inhibition is long lasting, that is the lasting up to the lifetime of the platelets. Whenever there is an attack of the myocardial infarction or suspicion that a person is suffering from the myocardial infarction, immediately aspirin is administered within 24 hours before or after the hospital arrival. It provides the additional mortality benefits in the patients in the STE, acute coronary syndrome, when given along with the fibrinolytic therapy. they are prescribed in the non-enteric coated form, that is 160 to 325 mg chewable tablet, and it is swallowed as soon as possible so that the onset of symptoms will quickly resolve. जो भी पेन है और जो ब्लॉकेट आ रही है आर्टरी की वो स्टॉप हो जाए. फर्दर मोर इफ द ट्रीटमेंट क्राइटेरिया इज टू द पेशेंट हैज टू अंडरगो टू द पीसीआई अगेन इट हैज टू बी टेक एस्पिरिन फॉर प्रोफिलैक्सिस. द डेली डोज ऑफ द एस्पिरिन इज द 75 टू 162 mg. द मोस्ट कॉमन डोज इज द 75 mg दैट इज रिकमेंडेड दियर आफ्टर एंड शुड बी कंटिन्यूड इनडेफिनेटली. डेली बेसिस पे एस्पिरिन लेनी पड़ती है. However, if the person is susceptible to the bleeding risk, then the patient should receive a low dose aspirin along with the P2Y12 inhibitor of the platelet that is preferred following the PCI. Furthermore, other types of the anti-inflammatory drugs like celecoxib, which is a cyclooxygenase 2 inhibitor, should be withdraw or discontinue at the time of the STEMI elevation because of the increased risk of death. These COX-2 inhibitors have a major potential to precipitate the heart failure and change in the QT interval. They have capability of the production of the reinfarction and heart failure and the myocardial rupture. These drugs should be discontinued. The major side effects of the aspirin include the GI upset, that is dyspepsia, nausea, vomiting, and there may be a GI bleeding. In emergency basis, non-enteric coated aspirin will be taken so that it easily absorb or quickly absorb from the GI tract. Or in case of normal dosing, normal basis pe we will take the enteric coated aspirin. This pathway shows that arachidonic acid is the major precursor which under the enzyme of phospholipase enzyme A will go under two pathway, which is the lipoxygenase pathway and cyclooxygenase pathway. In cyclooxygenase pathway, there will be the formation of prostaglandin, prostacyclin and thromboxane A. While in case of the lipoxygenase pathway, there will be the production of leukotrienes and the lipoxin. Furthermore, you must remember that bleeding is the main adverse effect of the aspirin, especially the GI bleeding, or there may be a hemorrhagic stroke bleeding at higher doses. The interaction exists between the ibuprofen and the NSAID aspirin. Both are the COX-1 inhibitor and they are mainly competing with the catalytic site. If it is taken along with the ibuprofen within 2 hours prior to the aspirin, it can obstruct the access of the aspirin to the serine residue and thereby antagonize the platelet inhibition effect by the aspirin. So if the person has to use ibuprofen and aspirin simultaneously, the care has to be taken that immediate release aspirin should be taken at least 1 hour before the ibuprofen or at least 8 hours after the ibuprofen. Another combination with celecoxib is that the cardiovascular effects may worsen, that may lead to the myocardial infarction. So celecoxib use should be avoided during MI. Other platelet inhibitors are the P2Y12 ATP receptor inhibitors that blocks the platelet aggregation, but the mechanism is different from the aspirin. In short, we can say that platelet contains two purinergic receptors, P2Y1 and P2Y2, and their activation is necessary for the activation of the platelets. When we inhibit these receptors, the result will be the prevention of the platelet aggregation. So platelet P2Y12 inhibitors are the clopidogrel and prasugrel and ticagrelor that blocks a subtype of the ADP receptors on platelets, prevent its binding to the receptor and subsequent expression of the platelet receptors that are GP2B3A receptors, reducing the platelet aggregation. They are also recommended along with the aspirin for the STE elevated myocardial infarction. Why they are used in combination with the aspirin? Because they prevent the subacute stent thrombosis. and on long term basis they prevent other cardiovascular thromboembolic events. And for how much of the time they are prescribed for at least 12 months of the patient that are undergoing the PCI, either whatever the cause of the myocardial infarction. So for the period of the 12 months they are prescribed for the prevention of the secondary myocardial infarction. 1 year के लिए दे रहे. However, if coronary artery bypass graft surgery is planned, CABG surgery is planned, then you have to withhold the clopidogrel or ticagrelor for 5 days and prasugrel at least 7 days to reduce the post-operative bleeding unless the need for revascularization outweighs the bleeding risk. So to decrease the bleeding, 1 week के लिए during the CABG surgery we will stop the use of the clopidogrel and the ticagrelor. Furthermore, if these drugs are also a substitute for the those patients which are aspirin sensitive or those who are intolerant to the aspirin, the choice of drug is the tegludipine and the clopidogrel. Clopidogrel is very related to the tegludipine. Both are causing the irreversible inhibition of the platelet P2Y12 receptors. No hypersensitivity reactions may be seen with aspirins, and the combination of the aspirin and clopidogrel is superior to the aspirin alone in the prevention of the secondary myocardial infarction. What are the doses? Doses may be different depending upon the practice. Usual dose is 300 mg oral. Loading dose, that is followed by the 75 mg oral daily in those patients which are already on the fibrillatex or those who are not receiving the reperfusion therapy. However, if age is more than 75 years, then the loading dose should be avoided. The loading dose will be doubled, that is 600 mg is recommended when the PCI is performed, except that the case in which after that, only the dose should be 300 mg that it will be given within 24 hours of the fibrinolytic therapy. So the normal dose is 300 mg while before the PCI the dose is 600 mg. And if the patient are receiving the fibrinolytic therapy, and then we have to maintain the dose of the clopidogrel up to 75 mg once during the hospitalization and up to 28 days. To further reduce the mortality and re-infarction without increasing the risk of the major bleeding. Anticoagulants ki dose badhane ki bajaye hum antiplatelet ki dose jo hai wo maintain karenge. For those adults that are younger than 75 years, along with the fibrinolytics, the first dose of the clopidogrel will be the 300 mg loading dose. For those patients who are not undergoing the reperfusion therapy, either by the PCI or fibrinolytics, then clopidogrel is preferred over the aspirin, and they should at least continue for 14 days up to 1 year. The dose of the prasugrel is 660 mg oral loading dose, followed by the 10 mg oral once for the patients weighing 60 kg or more, while ticagrelor is about 180 mg oral loading dose in the patient that are undergoing PCI, followed by the 90 mg oral twice daily. What are the side effects of the clopidogrel and prasugrel? These are the GI side effects like nausea, vomiting and diarrhea. However, a very rare type of the side effect, which is the thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura, is reported. Sometimes there is a bradyarrhythmias. Another point to be remembered is that these agents can prolong the bleeding with no antidote. While tegludipine is also associated with the severe hematological reactions like agranulocytosis along with the thrombotic thrombocytopenic purpura and aplastic anemia. Among them, clopidogrel is a drug of choice in which it has a lower type of the adverse reactions and it may have neutropenia. The drugs prasugrel and ticagrelor carry the black box warning due to the bleeding tendency. If we focus on another type of the mechanism to inhibit the platelet aggregation, then we have a choice of the glycoprotein 2B3A receptor inhibitors. These drugs block the final common pathway of the platelet aggregations, and they are inhibiting the cross-linking of platelets by the fibrinogen's bridges between the GP2B and 3A receptors on the platelet surface. What are the drug of choice? Amciclimab, that is the IV or administered IV or intracoronary administered. Then we have eptifibatide or triofiban. That these drugs are administered in patient with the STE elevation undergoing in the primary PCI, those who are treated with the unfractionated heparin. Remember that if the person are not undergoing PCI, the drugs should not be administered. These drugs should not be administered in those patients which are not undergoing PCI. Amciclimab 0.25 mg per kg is given as a IV bolus 10 to 60 minutes or about within 30 minutes before the start of the PCI, followed by the reduction in the dose, that is 0.125 mcg per kg per minute, that is of the maximum 10 microgram per minute for 12 hours. While the dosage of the eptifibatide is 180 microgram per kg IV bolus, that repeated in 10 minutes, followed by the infusion of the 2 microgram per kg per minute for 18 to 24 hours after the PCI. Then we have the tirofiban in the dosage of 25 microgram per kg IV bolus. Then it is given up to 0.5 mg per kg per minute up to 18 to 24 hours after PCI. Remember, the routine use of these drugs, amciclimab, eptifibatide, is not recommended in patients who have received the fibrinolytics or in those receiving the bivalirudin because of the increasing bleeding risk. Bleeding bahut badh jayegi. कंट्रोल करना मुश्किल होगी, एंटीडोट नहीं अवेलेबल है, तो फॉर दैट रीजन इनका रूटीन यूज है वो अवॉइडेड है, रिकमेंड नहीं है, स्पेशली अगर फिब्रिनोलाइटिक्स हैं. व्हाट इज द मेजर प्रॉब्लम विद दीज ड्रग्स? ब्लीडिंग इज द मोस्ट कॉमन एडवर्स इफेक्ट. फर्दरमोर इफ अ पेशेंट हैज अ हिस्ट्री ऑफ हेमरेजिक स्ट्रोक और रीसेंट इस्केमिक स्ट्रोक, दीज ड्रग्स शुड बी अवॉइडेड. दीज ड्रग्स शुड बी अवॉइडेड इन द क्रॉनिक किडनी डिजीज that increases the bleeding tendency. The dose should be reduced, especially eptifibatide and triofiban. The dose should be reduced in renal impairment. Furthermore, an acute immune type thrombocytopenia may occur in about 5% of the patient that receiving the amciclimab, or in 1% that receiving the eptifibatide or tirofiban.